Computer fans, air conditioners, and other background sounds can show up in your audio recordings without you even realizing they were there when you did the actual recording. In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily remove some of these background sounds using Tracktion Waveform Free or Pro, and I'm only using a free plugin. I'm Zane, welcome to Audio Tech TV, where it's my goal to help you conquer the tech so you can unleash your creativity, and I do this by providing easy to follow audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews. Links to all of the software mentioned in this video are down in the description, so you can head down there if you need any of this stuff, but right now let's jump into this Tracktion Waveform tutorial. All right, first I want to set your expectations. This isn't going to magically remove big noises from the background. It's more about removing hisses, hums, fan sounds, and that sort of thing. This can be great in noisy rooms where you record your vocals, podcasts, videos, or whatever else. So here's my audio clip right here. All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan, and you might also be hearing my lighting fan. So you can hear there's a bit of a hum. It's the fans, like I say in there, it's the computer laptop and a mix between that and my lighting fan. Plus, I also heard in there the sounds like the hard drive on my laptop was making some noise as well. So we're going to be getting rid of that. So the first thing I need to do is load up a plugin. So just go to add new plugin. And the plugin that I'm using is the MCompressor from Melda Production. This is a free plugin. I've included a link to it down in the description. And if you need help installing plugins in Tracktion Waveform, I'll also include a link to my video showing you how to install plugins into Waveform. So once you have this loaded up onto the track, just click on presets right here in the middle. And then you want to click on the one that says noise gate. Just double click on that, then click close. And your screen should look like this. Let's listen to what it sounds like just with the basic preset, nothing edited. All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan. So that's pretty choppy. And it's extremely easy to make this sound better. We just go to this node right here. And you just want to click on that. So first I'm going to start playing it and then I'm going to edit this. So here we are playing it.
All right, this is an example of audio.
Now you click this node,
background noise,
just drag it to the left.
Fan, and you might also be hearing my lighting fan.
All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan, and you might also be hearing my lighting fan. All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing. And that sounds pretty good right there. You want to keep dragging it over to the left until you can't hear that noise in the background anymore and your voice isn't chopped up like the way it was before. So I'm just going to play the clip again and I'm going to turn the compressor on and off so you can hear the difference. So we'll start with it on.
All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan and you might also be hearing my lighting fan.
All right, still a little choppy on my voice. I'm just going to bring this back a little bit more. Let's listen to that.
All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan, and you might also be hearing my lighting fan.
All right, that's pretty good right there. And now, because it does bring the level down a bit, what we're going to do is go to this node right in the middle, the circle there. And just bring it up a little bit. So you click and drag on it and it kind of curving there. And let's have a listen to what it's done now.
All right, this is an example of audio recording with some background noise. What you're hearing is my laptop fan, and you might also be hearing my lighting fan.
So that doesn't sound too bad right there. And like I said, you can use this for podcasts, for vocals that you're singing, for your video work, or wherever else you need to edit out some background noise from audio. Now with the free version of this plugin, you can't save the preset. So if you wanted to save this as your own preset so you can easily load it up every time, you can't do that within the plugin itself. But Tracktion Waveform has this tool down here where you can save a preset right there. So
click save, and I'm going to click create new preset, and I'll call this background remover. I think I spelled it wrong by accident there, but now let's just change this to, we'll change it to overdrive. Looks totally different now, but I want to bring up my preset. I click load, background remover, and there is our preset that we saved right there.
And if you want even more Tracktion Waveform tutorials, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Audio Tech TV, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.